And I want you to see this morning that it is a must as Christians, believers, saints, that our faith stand trial. Because when something stands trial, it has to do with that thing being proven to be genuine. See, you really don't know if you have genuine faith until you go through a genuine test. Woo. And see, the test gonna let you know if your faith is real. Oh, let me break it down like this. See, when the test come or when your faith stand trial, there's going to be a verdict as to whether you guilty of living by faith or you've been found innocent. Ooh, Lord have mercy. Based on that, just tell your neighbor the subject this morning. Your faith must stand trial. Woo, look at somebody this morning. Tell them your faith must stand trial. Look at somebody like you know they going through something this morning and tell them, don't you worry about what you're going through. That's a God test. Your faith must stand trial. Some of us don't understand that. But trial simply means, again, that when it comes to faith, our faith in God will be put to the test. It's going to be tested. James wanted the 12 tribes to know, again, that when it came to their faith, yeah, y'all are experiencing something that could be deemed or looked at as horrendous, but you need to understand that it is simply your God allowing your faith to be tested. And you have to teach like this because there are pseudo or false preachers who will tell God's people that they shouldn't ever go through trials, that you shouldn't ever go through a test. That matter of fact, there are some preachers that would go so far as to tell saints that if you going through something, it's because you have did something that you had no business doing. Oh, come on, somebody. Even Job, when his friends came to visit him, and we know according to the text that Job was going through something because God had put Job before the enemy, letting the devil know that he's going to stand no matter how I test him because of what you say about him. But when Job's friends arrived and looked at him, they thought that Job had somehow sinned against God and brought this trouble upon himself. And some of us are like that. We don't need others to tell us that, because when you go through, you beat yourself up. You try to condemn yourself and try to figure out, Lord, what have I done wrong? God, have I angered you, Lord? Have I did what I had no business to do? Lord, is there something that I have somehow been saying that you are not pleased with? And so we go through this. Some of us go through this long, drawn out pity party. Where we're trying to see what we have done wrong. But see, I've been saved now for 20 plus years. And it's one thing that I clearly understand, and that is that trouble is not just a part of life. Listen to me, saint, but trouble is a part of being a Christian. It's a part of living by faith, because faith has to be tested. Oh, I wish you tell somebody your faith gonna be tested now. And some of us right now, you're going through something that's the testing of your faith. You're going through it and it's painful, may even be discomforting to you. But child of God, you have to recognize that is simply a God test. And when God has permitted or ordained a test to enter into our lives, it don't matter how much you praise him, you got to go through that test. You come on, somebody. It don't matter how much you give and lay upon the altar. You're going to have to go through certain things in order for God to use you as mightily as he desires to use you. Oh, come on, somebody. Even what you're going through this morning, God is going to use your situation and is going to allow you to minister to other people. You, because of what you have gone through, and you didn't break down, because you didn't quit, because you didn't throw in the towel, you're going to be able to tell somebody to hold on, because God will show out, because you will be a witness that God will permit trouble, but he'll never put more on you than what you are able to bear. That's the reason some of us clapping right now. We trust our God like that. He ain't gonna put more on me than I can handle, but I've got to go through this test right here. Some of us better listen. You've got to go through that. You can't go around that. You can't go under that. You've got to go through that test and come out with a testimony, because your faith must be tested. Are y'all hearing me? Now, what it also means when it's on trial is that faith, a living by faith, is going to go under an examination. And anytime you're living by faith, there will always be evidence to back up what you're living by. For instance, if you truly live by faith, the evidence will be there in your thinking. The evidence will be there in how you talk. I love what Jesus told a group of folk. He said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth will speak. See, if I'm living by faith, then it's going to come out of my mouth. I can't help it. I'm just going to talk how God is going to do it. That's just the way that I talk. It may look bad, but you ain't going to hear me talk bad. You're going to hear me say that God going to show up. You're going to hear me say God going to bring us out. You're going to hear me talking better, even though when you look at me, you may not be able to see that better that I'm talking about. But you got to keep your eye on me, because this is how I talk. This is how I talk. I talk faith. I talk word. I talk. Anybody talk word? Anybody talk faith? See, that's where your evidence is going to be. It's going to be found again in your thinking. It's going to be found in how you talk. And finally, evidence will be in your actions or your choices. In other words, if I'm living by faith, it should be evident by the choices that I make. Let me back up. I said it should be evident, though I'm going through something, I choose not to panic. I said I choose not to panic. It's enough that would cause a certain person to push the panic, but not me. I choose not to panic. I choose not to worry about this, because it's something that I can't change. And so it's not going to get me all stressed out. Oh, Lord. It's not going to cause me to act out of character. If I am, in fact, a friendly person, then I'm going to remain friendly up under trials. I'm not going to mistreat folk who have nothing to do with the trial that I'm going through. Am I preaching to anybody? You have to understand, child of God, that your faith will stand trial. Now, when I say must stand trial, it means that it's absolutely necessary. It is a necessity that your faith stand trial. And you know, I love it when I think about it, because it says about a child of God that you don't just get to talk the talk without walking the walk. Yeah, I need to say that again. You don't get to just say stuff just to say it. Come on, anybody ever seen somebody when you're going through in your body, they want you to know that God can do anything, save, fail. But when they go through in their body, they want to lay down and quit. No, you don't get to tell me that. And then when you go through something, you ain't pray. You told me that I needed to just give God a praise. Now, I done sat up here for 2 Sundays in a row watching you fold your hand in the praise service. So I want to put the pill that you put on me. I want you to swallow your own pill. I want to see you praise him and you bowing in your body. That's what you told me. You told me don't worry about it. I'm telling you don't worry about it. I dare you to tell a couple of folks, you don't get to just say stuff. You don't get to just say stuff. God, I wish I could just come out there and tap some of y'all that love quoting scriptures that you know you ain't living. You don't get to just throw a scripture out there that you ain't living. What's wrong with you, girl? You got to live that thing. Stop quoting the scripture and you ain't living it. Just like me, I don't get to just preach and not live what I preach. Woo! Do y'all hear me? I don't get to get up here and talk about the trying of faith and my faith not be tried. No.